Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the set of all these different lifecycle methods, this get snapshot before update is little tricky. Apart from that, we have already covered all the different lifecycle methods. Those are kind of simple, easy, should component update and get derived state from props. Those we are able to understand. Now, if we see this, get snapshot before update is actually working in conjunction with componented update. And how actually it is working? It is working just after render. So it is actually getting the snapshot of the DOM which we are going to apply on the UI and going to give instruction to component did update, okay, do this thing to actually manage the UI before actual update happens. Okay, so this is actually a little tricky what this get snapshot before update is doing. Because it is telling component did update, okay, this is the new change is going to come. You have to deal with this DOM change like this. Like you have a chat list, simple chat list, a WhatsApp chat, Facebook chat, and you can see that you keep adding from and to, a lot of messages are coming. Once your screen is full, you wanted to automatically add a scroll bar or you wanted to do something. So in that case, get snapshot before update can calculate, okay, after adding this new message from my friend, my chat list will become full and I just need to add a scroll height or some property so that this content is scrollable and the latest content appear to me. Okay, so get snapshot before update is being called right after render method is called. This get snapshot before update will call after that. Okay, we already know that this is a little tricky and get snapshot before update will return some value which will be used by componented update. Okay, so get snapshot before update will refer to the value just before the DOM is updated. So even though render has happened, but we don't see the actual change right now, there is a delay. So once the DOM actual changes have not been applied, this then get snapshot before update is getting the current state of the DOM before changes are applied. And it will just do the calculations and it will say, okay, do this to the componented mount. So it is actually applying the required visual changes to be done whenever some change is coming to the UI. Okay, so simple example is like you have a chat list, you keep adding from and to, but when your chat list become full, how you will know? So get snapshot before update can do the scroll height check. And then it will let this component did update know, okay, do this. So we have seen that get snapshot before update is accessing previous props and previous state. That means you can actually calculate what currently on the screen is before the actual change is applied on the UI. Okay, so within this method, I mean, this can return null or this can return some value. So get snapshot before method doesn't work on its own. It is meant to work with this component did update lifecycle method. And what component did update do is this lifecycle invoke just after this snapshot. And as with what it is doing is here we have, if you have seen the code, it is having this third argument, which is a snapshot. Okay, so this snapshot is actually feeded by the previous method get snapshot before update. Okay. So whatever we are returning from get snapshot before update, like you will be returning, okay, let's return null. So whatever you are returning, that argument is being passed to component did mount as a third argument. So snapshot is currently null. Or you can return something which can give instruction to component did update to change the DOM behavior based on what you are returning. Because it is calculating based on the previous props and previous state, doing some calculation and returning some object. That will be passed as a snapshot to this component did update method. Okay, so I mean, it is trying to solve a lot of problems, like simple is auto scroll you wanted to add, some kind of a DOM behavior you wanted to add based on the update which you have received. Simple example I will just try to show and will try to share it with you guys. This is just a code snippet from GitHub. Okay, so get snapshot before update, we are accessing the current state and the previous state. Current state you can access and current props you can access directly using this dot state, this dot props. But we now have access to previous state and previous props also. So now with this calculation, what I'm checking is chat list is greater than the previous chat list. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to actually move the latest message coming from my friend to the top. So here I'm just checking the updating the scroll height. I mean, I'm just accessing the reference of the DOM node and I'm updating the scroll height. And once that is done, I'm returning this value to the snapshot of this. So it is some kind of a height I'm passing to this component did update. And if snapshot is not null, I'm just doing subtraction of this height, subtraction of this snapshot height from the scroll height. And we are scrolling that to the top. So whenever the new message is coming up, it is always getting shown at the correct position. Right, this is the basic use case of understanding get snapshot before update and component did update. Okay, thanks everyone.